This week in Arkansas, I saw a car that had a couple of decals on the back about Bitcoin. Seeing references to Bitcoin on a car reminded me that the technology for the mark of the beast is here, and as the Bible warns us, anyone who takes the mark of the beast will be damned. I want to remind anyone watching this video to not take the mark of the beast, but trust God and keep the faith in our Lord Jesus Christ.
Mark of the Beast.
Beast.
Mark of the Beast. 666. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666.
So are you a believer?
Well, Bitcoin is better than currency in that.
Another currency. And I think that Bitcoin answers a lot of questions that, you know, we don't know yet if this is a real free market attempt, or is it like the NSA or the Federal Reserve getting us used to a digital currency that they can track?
We learned that our governments, working in concert, have created a system of worldwide mass surveillance, watching everything we do.
I wasn't feeling very well, went in for a checkup, and they said that their computers are down. I go, what's going on here? And they go, well, we were hacked.
The attackers use what's called ransomware to lock Hollywood Presbyterian Medical Center out of its own medical records. The hackers were asking for a payment in Bitcoin.
Once again, we hear about Bitcoin as being the currency of exchange for these ransom things. That's what happened to the attacks last week. Why is it so difficult to trace Bitcoin? I would think that with all of our energy, with the NSA working on it, et cetera, we could track down who is responsible for an account to which a ransom is being paid.
The NSA has the greatest surveillance capabilities that we've ever seen in history. Now, what they will argue is that they don't use this for nefarious purposes against American citizens.
Wannacry? A new ransomware using a pre-released NSA exploit kit has been going viral.
Bitcoins are an online currency that are hard to trace. It's a preferred ransom method for hackers.
The question we now have to ask is if technologically it is possible to make an impenetrable device or system where the encryption is so strong that there's no key, there's no door at all, then how do we apprehend, what mechanisms do we have available to even do simple things like tax enforcement? Because if in fact you can't crack that at all, government can't get in, then everybody's walking around with a Swiss bank account in their pocket.
And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand, or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name.